Welcome again to the second tutorial for the course English 4. Once again, we're going to be reviewing some of the grammar that you find in your book Ventures 4. Today we're going to look at the present perfect and present perfect continuous and adjectives ending in it and ing. Okay, let's start with the present perfect. When do we use the present perfect? Well, the present perfect is used to talk about recently finished actions. Let's take a look at the structure of the present perfect. We're going to have or has plus the verb in the past participle. Let's take a look at the example. Peter has finished his homework. Okay, here we have has and the verb in the past participle. Now remember that has or have will depend on the subject. In this sentence, I'm using has because the subject it's Peter, okay? Examples. Darwin has painted the house. Has and the verb in the past participle. I'm using has because the subject is Darwin. Next example. Cesar has finished the marathon. Has plus the verb in the past participle. And the last example. They have built a new machine. Okay, we're using have in this case because the subject is they, plural. The present perfect continuous. Well, the present perfect continuous is used to talk about actions that started in the past and continue now or may continue in the future. And the structure is have or has plus been plus the verb with ing. Example, I have been studying Italian for 3 months. If you were to translate this to Spanish, this would be Yo he estado estudiando italiano por 3 meses. Let's take a look at these 2 examples. Vanessa and Paul have been teaching English for 15 years. Vanessa y Paul han estado enseñando inglés por 15 años. So as you can see, the structure is very similar to the one in Spanish. And the last example, I have been walking for 2 hours. Yo he estado caminando por 2 horas. Okay, adjectives ending in ed and ing. Now, the movie was interesting. ing. We're using ing because we are describing the movie. The movie was interesting. Jorge is interested in this book. We're going to use ed, okay, when we're talking about condition or how the person feels. Jorge is interested in this book. That noise is irritating. So again, we're describing the noise. The noise is irritating. I am irritated by that noise. Okay? So we're talking, we're describing how we feel. I am irritated by that noise. And that's the end for this second tutorial. Thank you.